Ladies and gentlemen, Atilia Haron is back.
Hi, hello.
Right here on The Breakfast Show. She's got a new album out. Yes, you've got
it's Inda. Called Inda. Woo. And it's here.
Oh, chee, chee, chee,
on The Breakfast Show. Look at it. It's so very Inda. Yeah, we launched this album in June 15th to be exact. So that's about 3 months ago. But we had a month of break where we had Raya and Puasa.
Exactly.
We were still having Raya, but I'm now starting to promote the album.
Was it difficult to stop the promotions halfway? How's the support been so far?
It was okay because usually during bulan puasa, I try not to do much also because, you know, rest kat rumah and all that because I'm very kurus, so it's very hard for me to puasa. So
itulah,
I try to just not do anything. So the whole of bulan puasa was a halt. And now we are busy promoting the album. I'll be starting this Sunday actually because I'll be having a showcase at No Black Tie.
All right.
This Sunday.
Okay.
And also on the 15th and the 16th, I'll be at Alexis.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be doing songs from the album. We've got 10 songs on the album.
Nice, nice, nice. Of course, full album. That's for sure.
Which I produced myself with Tokun.
Who you? Producer also.
Itu aja.
Singer and producer also.
That was my ultimate goal when I was in school. Teachers were always asking what's your cita-cita. My cita-cita was to produce my own album. So
really?
Yeah.
Not just bukan saya nak nyanyi, saya nak produce album sendiri.
And got tiga kan?
Oh, ada tiga.
Ada tiga kan? Nombor satu, nombor dua, tiga. Producing album was I think number dua or something. First was penyanyi, and then number tiga was penghibur or something related.
So you've achieved 1, 2, and 3. Congratulations.
Thank you.
More than many other people have done in their life. Nicely done.
Yeah, I've always wanted to do that. And I think it's actually very fulfilling as an artist. Mm-hmm. If you produce your own album, you write your own songs. When you get into the studio, you sing, you have your perasaan penuh, and plus you write your lyrics.
Your whole life, your whole emotion, your heart and soul into
it's
this
in
album.
Inda.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what was the big difference from your first or your fledgling album, Sangka?
The first album, Sangka, was produced by my idol, Roslan Aziz and Jason Wu, which I had a lot of experience. I picked up a lot of experience from that.
Mm-hmm.
And
producing experience.
Producing experience. Yeah. And he wanted me to ultimately produce my own.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I did and that's where I am. And the difference would probably be, I think this time around my songs are more easy listening and I think it's more radio friendly.
Mm-hmm.
And as opposed to the first one, which was very experimental, but I love that album. It was a very musician album.
Yes, I love
but
that
this
album.
One, if you listen, you'll be like, hey, I can relate to this song.
Ah.
I can hear this song on the radio.
I can jive to this, I can jive to that.
Yeah, you know,
that's the basic difference. Yeah,
it's very light.
Right. And it's a full album, 10 songs as well.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, eligible for AIM. yes. here's the thing. She's got some collaborations in here, including one from No Hujan.
Yes,
and now he's a popular boy. He's collaborating with everybody.
Yes, because he's very talented. The first time I heard No sing was at Istana Budaya when he opened for Butterfingers a long time ago.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I've never heard him sing live before that.
Mm-hmm.
So when I heard that, I was like, oh my God, this guy's got magic. He's got some jazz power inside
some aura.
Him, which dia pun tak tahu.
Jazz power.
Yeah. So I can't remember how we met or how we first communicated, but he came over to my house and he brought his album Hujan, and then I think I was like, okay, that's it, I want to have a duet with No. So a friend of mine, Mike Blumendahl from Imaginex, wrote Old Love, and I thought it'd be great to sing it with someone, and at that time I didn't think of
like
No,
siapa.
This is an English jazz song. So when I approached No, I emailed him the song, he said okay, and the first time we sang it together was at my launch. Yeah, because Noah's a busy boy.
Yes, he is.
So it's very hard to get him to.
Not that she said busy boy, because Noah has. You cannot describe him any way else but a boy, even though he's 40 years old.
A very naughty boy.
No, jangan marah, no. Okay,
dia Justin Bieber sebenarnya.
Oh, dia Justin.
Kan, rambut dia. Tak tahu sekarang rambut dia dah lain.
Kalau dia tengah makan sekarang, dia dengar tu mesti dia tersembuh. Okay, it's Justin Bieber.
No, Kublai Khan.
No, Kublai Khan. Well, of course, we can't wait to hear that one, of course. It's in English. That's going to be very interesting.
We have four
well.
English songs, six Melayu songs. Because I think a lot of fans out there want, you know, they want me to have English songs in my album, because I always sing English songs when I do my corporate shows, my No Black Tie shows, my Alexis shows.
And you've got a strong fan base that have followed you everywhere.
Alhamdulillah, yes. I just found out recently that I've had 6.3 million hits on my website.
Hujung! 6.3 million?
Banyak gila kan?
Itu dia banyak gila.
Betul ke ni? Entah-entah dia nak cari orang lain.
Anyway,
so, I'm very active
online.
Online. my website, my Twitter, and everything is linked through my website, which is www.atelia.us.
Ah, exactly. .us, I wanted to say that. But here's the thing, many artists are jumping on this online bandwagon, but a lot of people, the feedback that we've been getting, susah nak buat duit lah sekarang ni, dengan online ni semua, download ni semua. How to compete? I want to sell CD, so cannot sell CD. What's your take on this?
No lah, I think for me, it's just a matter of bringing my music
to another level.
To another level, bringing my music across, and it's easy. It's just very, very convenient. With the click of a button, you can listen to maybe 30 seconds of my music on my website, and then nice lah, and then I can go and get it. You know, instead of just trying to go to the shops and getting it.
Headphone. Saya mau dengar.
So I think it's more of a plus point lah.
More of a plus point, yeah.
And plus, yeah. For me personally, to produce an album is to get your profile out. You know, to get corporate shows, to get more fan base, to get to sing more in jazz festivals, music festivals. It's not a matter of just selling albums. I don't mind people downloading my song. But pay.
That's the thing. But here's the thing for Malaysia artists. Once your songs get downloaded or pirated on LimeWire or Meta Cafe, whatever, then you've made it. Yay, aku dah berjaya. Orang copy.
I didn't say that. But I kind of agree.
But here's another issue that I wanted to talk about as well. When we talk about online sales, as well, we talk about it's a bad problem that we have, piracy. Yeah. As a musician, when do you think Malaysians will finally wake up and start paying?
When people realize the talent and the hard work that has been put in producing one album. You know, it sounds very merry and la di da, but the process is
painstaking, yeah.
Really, yes. From the recording of the bass line till the final mix till the mastering, it's a long process. So until people appreciate that and sayang dia penyanyi pujaan, as how they say it. Yeah, I think. But we're going that way, I think.
We're going that way.
Yeah, we are.
Excellent.
Yeah, I see a lot of people going, oh my god, you download songs?
Excellent. But you've got a very, very strong fan base as well, and a lot of people like your purist, especially that's why a lot of people like Sangka. It was a musician's album, you know. That's why I liked it as well.
It came from your
Exactamundo, man. But with this one also coming from the heart. But as you said, it'll be a bit more radio friendly. So do you feel that you'll alienate a certain part of your fan base?
Oh yeah, I read this blog comment the other day saying that I've actually moved away from my original plan, and what's happened to you? You've gone commercial. I think it's just a step for me to get more listeners.
Absolutely.
And you know, it's a way of, I don't know, maybe on for my third album I'd probably go industrial, go back a bit and go gila. But this is me now. I'm feeling very indah. I'm feeling very chilled, and I'm very happy with my life now, and it reflects in my album. So yeah, I don't want to go dark.
So basically, it's just a piece of Atelia's life right now. Life is peachy for you. I mean, what's the latest happening in your life?
I'm gonna be doing a lot of promotion for the album. I'll be performing a lot, and I will be doing a lot of jazz club crawls around KL.
Jazz club crawl.
Around Malaysia actually, and then apa lagi? So far, that's it.
Just work, and work on it.
Work. I'll be producing more concerts because I just produced Malam Nada Biru, and we've got a few more coming out soon.
Nada Biru tu?
Three.
Sorry.
The second one was with Yuna and Najwa.
That's right. And I heard rave reviews for that one as well. So we can't wait for Nada Biru 3 that's happening. Because Atelia, please bring us more good music.
Inshallah.
Cewa. But maybe last question. Love ke apa ke? Asyik kerja je, boring lah.
Kan? Malu lah.
Atelia Harun malu? No such thing.
Malu lah.
No such thing.
My love now is my music and my friends, my fellow slappers who helped me for my Indah video. And Daphne's not here today, so I'm Daphne hiking.
Well, celebrities with pet projects. And of course, most of their pet projects are pink in colour. There you go.
Yeah, we do a lot of charity.
Yes,
we do a lot of charity work.
Good stuff. So you've got your charity work going. You've got your album that's already dalam pasaran.
And Malam Nada Biru.
Exactly. So watch out for the latest from Atelia. Of course, you can get this at all record stores. Of course, you can also go online, grab it. It's at RM30, if I'm not mistaken.
Correct. If you book it online, we'll send it to you. It's RM30. And if it it's, you know, if I'm not doing anything and if you're in the Klang Valley, I probably might just drop by and send you the CD. Wah, and sign it for you.
Sendiri anda?
Because I've done that, yeah, a couple of times.
Ah, itulah dia, Malaysian celebrities. Like that, you know, personalized service. Dia datang dengan pos laju punya outfit.
I like that.
But then again, many male fans of yours say, hey, pos laju hati apa, yo. Jangan.
Dia dah lain lah ni.
Sabar. While Nazruddin Habibur Rahman cools down here on the breakfast show set, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Much appreciated.
Thank
Selamat Hari Raya.
Selamat Hari Raya. Hari Raya yang indah.
Yes. Dapatkan Hari Raya yang indah, of course.
Thank you very much.
Right about now. And I'm going to take a quick break right here.